Okay, hello, Mr. Peter again. We are at Union Square on Monday, Labor Day, toiling away. And it's peanut season. Most people, when they think of peanuts, they think of Georgia. And definitely this is not a peanut year, a good year for peanuts in New York, because we have had such a yo-yo of weather. And so the yield on these things is really, really low. However, the taste is really, really good. So a fresh peanut like this is, never had a fresh peanut, you haven't had a peanut. So these things boiled are out of this world, and that's all you gotta do with them. Some of the best restaurants in the city, that's what they do. They buy them, boil them, and serve them. I mean, they're 10 times better than edamame as far as I'm concerned. Obviously, there's more sophisticated ways of making these things, but to me, that's the simplest and best and tastiest way. And you can sit there and eat 5 pounds of them and not even know it. Although it costs you a pretty penny to do that. Because we yield very, very small yields on the farm. We were hoping to get about 0.5 pound per plant, and we're only about 0.15 pounds per plant, so didn't work out, but nonetheless, it's a crop and it's exciting. So what the heck's been going on the farm lately? Well, Friday night it got down to 37 degrees. In my 20 years of farming, I don't remember ever 37 degrees in August or early September. Our 10-day forecast looks more like fall than summer. Usually in up until the middle of September, we still have some 80 degree weather, but it's all 60s and 70s for the highs and 40s and 50s for the lows. So all of our summer stuff is not happy. All your squashes, your peppers, your eggplants, so they're gonna really shut down and they won't ripen very fast. Same with tomatoes. However, our spinaches and pak choys and lettuces and beets and all the winter stuff, this is really lovely weather for them. This is their California weather. So they love it, they grow well. And a few more days, we're actually gonna have winter squash coming to the market, which spells the end of summer as we know it.
So let me ask you, even if we get like a hot spell, for like September, October, how do plants react to them?
Well, the problem with living so far up from the equator is that we have another phenomenon. It's called, right now we're losing 2 to 3 minutes of daylight per day. So plants react to temperature and they react to the length of day. So if they're daylight sensitive, or not daylight, but day length sensitive, we're losing day length. So it doesn't matter that in October I have an 80 day degree, if I can get one of those. Yeah, it'll make the spinach grow really good, but you know, by then tomatoes and all that kind of stuff, it's too late. So, you know, if in 2 weeks or 10 days we get, you know, 80 degrees for 10-15 days, sure, it'll help the tomatoes that are left out there ripen a little faster, but they're not going to ripen at the pace of say July and August, because there's just not enough, there's not enough heat in the day, because the day itself is shorter, a lot shorter, and the night is getting a lot longer.
So what do you do? Who are you? What's your name?
My name is Cesar Gutierrez. I'm the executive sous-chef at Café Boulud, New York.
Awesome.
So with the sunflower, I've been playing around with it, using the petals on one of our dishes. But I end up tourneing the actual choke and treating it like an artichoke. And we're going to cook it by wool. So we can use the Jerusalem artichoke, which is the root of the sunflower. The actual artichoke choke. The sunflower choke. And the seeds eventually.
What's a choke?
That's what we call the heart of the artichoke.
Uh-huh.
So it's the whole center after you remove all the petals and everything. it's the whole center, so I'm treating the sunflower itself like an artichoke.
So
I basically get a knife and clean up the whole outside, remove the stem, remove all the seeds, peel it down, and then cook it barigul, which is a mixture of carrots, celery, onions, chicken stock, white wine, herbs, and olive oil.
Do you do anything with the seeds?
I want to toast them, salt them, and then sprinkle on top of the actual choke. But this guy's already, I wouldn't be able to use this one, but a fresh sunflower would be ideal. Uh-huh. Remove the petals, use the petals as garnish, use the little brown spots to sprinkle on, it gives a nice sunflower flavor. And then the choke of the sunflower is what I would cook barigul. And sunflower like this that I had, that's already going into seed, mm-hmm. I would toast, remove the seeds, and then sprinkle on top.
Yeah, we're good. Yeah.
That sounds amazing.
Yeah.
Where does that dish come from?
I don't know. One day I decided to try the sunflower itself after I plucked it.
Uh-huh.
It reminded me of an artichoke. And I'm like, the root of the sunflower is a Jerusalem artichoke. So I said, you know, why not try Jerusalem artichoke, and the sunflower? And that's actually all works well.
That sounds amazing. So you like experimenting with...
Yeah.
With yours.
With the produce.
Produce.
Yeah. It's fun.
How'd you start doing that?
Just curiosity. Just, you know, like, there's only so much you can do with, like, all the same things, you know, like, so you start playing around with flavors, start playing around with different items, how to cut something differently, make it look different on the plate.
Yeah.
Use the tops of a carrot, for example, with the carrot, et cetera, just to make some, change it up a little bit, make it different.
How old were you when you started getting into that?
I started cooking when I was 16, but it wasn't until I was like maybe like 22. Once I actually had like technique down and I was properly trained, that I could like actually start playing with things.
Uh-huh.
So I guess first I need to be trained in order for me to be creative.
Wow.
Yeah. Once you know, and once you start knowing the produce, you start putting things together and go from there.
So what's your next adventure?
My next adventure? Doing the Bocuse d'Or, which is the Culinary Olympics, and representing Team USA.
So what does that entail?
That entails 2 years of my life training for a competition that has 66 countries involved, and only 3 countries get to place either bronze, silver, or gold. And last year, or in 2017, the US took gold for the first time in 30 years.
Wow.
So that's my next adventure. Thank you.
Pleasure meeting you.
Likewise.
Thank you.
Ciao. Thank you.
Sasha, you take the red, I take the orange.
Orange.
What's not your body?
Special model.
Hey, so what are you kids cooking?
We eat them raw.
Really? Awesome. Are they sweet?
Yes.
How do you pick a good pepper?
This looks cool.
Hmm?
This looks cool.
Yeah, it does look cool.
I like that other one you got.
Yeah, Mom.
Your family has been getting all these amazing vegetables.
Yes. Yeah, so we love fresh vegetables and chopped cucumbers with tomatoes, green onions, and red bell peppers, and flax oil is absolutely the best. You should try that. And vegetable ratatouille, like bell peppers, squash, you can put cauliflower, you can put eggplant, onions, and carrots, and steam it, or just saute in coconut or olive oil. That would make a great summer vegetable meal. And the best part, it's not sprayed. So basically you see this cucumber, it's not gonna last for long because it's not sprayed. So you're not consuming all the parabens, pesticides, and all that stuff. So that's why we're here.
How did you get your kids to love it so much?
Because I love it. It's very easy. Whatever you love, they love. Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
Your kids are like so into She's eating the pepper. It's like
yeah. Yeah. Those are mine.
Yeah. Rainbow. Rainbow.
Pray for the people in Houston.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, that could have been us. We've had our Sandy, but this is even worse, so. And we've got, I guess, a very busy hurricane season ahead of us, according to the meteorologist. So, and we've seen the brunt of that a couple of times, so we're praying that it stays away.
All right, my friend. See you at the market.
See you at the market. Have some peanuts.
Thank you.